I'm thinking of like a creature buried underground in like these little buildings or like it's like fingers or something. That was a really weird mental image. I apologize for that. What's up, Rat Fam? Today, I want to jump back into the terrifyingly creepy world of SCP creatures, oh, and all the nightmare fuel that they hold. Like my other SCP videos, I'm going to be using y'all's comments as suggestions for which creatures we should explore next, and we're going to focus on the description of those creatures instead of the entire file. So, of course, like always, if you want to go explore the entire file after the video, please, there'll always be links down below in the description. So let's get to it. The first SCP that we're going to explore today is SCP-1730, and right away the file looks completely different than the other ones. What is this? By order of the Overseer Council. That sounds legit and scary. Certain parts of this file are level 3-1730 classified. I don't know what that means. Due to the ongoing research into SCP-1730, all neutralized anomaly declassification policies are suspended until further notice. Standard classification policies are in effect. Unauthorized access is forbidden. If the SCP world was real, what would happen if they found out that I was exploring all these files, like some parallel universe where these are actual government redacted top secret type files, and I'm the only person that managed to get a hold of them somehow, like there was like a hole in the system of security? What would they do to me? Would I be taken to the Foundation and like disposed of? Would I be used as like a test subject? I don't want to think about that. That's too scary. The object class for this SCP is considered neutralized. Just off like first impressions, because that's what I like to do for these videos, is just focus on like my first impressions versus like the narration of the entire file. This is a weird one. Now, I feel like I say that a lot, but I mean it in a different way for this one. This file looks the most legitimately government-esque, that was a weird way of describing it, than the other ones. What is all this? Big Bend Ranch State Park, Texas, USA. Main office of SCP-1730, primary access to basement levels below the structure. Is this like a site and it's not a creature? I'm confused. If you're new here, hi, hello, my name's Kelina. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you join the Rat Fam by hitting subscribe today. Normally, I like to just focus on the description of the creature because I think that's just really fun to get my first impression of what these creepy monster things are. But this one is so different and my curiosity is peaked. So since it is different, I do want to explore a little bit of these containment updates that it has. Dangerous biological and cognito-hazardous entities, so I'm assuming it attacks your cognitive functions, have resulted in high casualties of security rescue teams. Mobile Task Force Zeta 9, Mole Rats, has been assigned to all current exploration efforts. I'm assuming that's the first update, but it's redacted and I wonder why. Why is that date redacted but the newest one isn't? Do they not want us to know how long this has been going on for? But the last update was on June 22nd, 2017. Due to the events detailed in Addendum 1730.9, SCP-1730, so many numbers, has been reclassified as neutralized. Additional research efforts are ongoing. Debriefing reports will become available as they are declassified. A file serve notice. The following is the SCP-1730 data file as it appeared before its reclassification as neutralized. Some inconsistencies may persist. That's a lot of jargon. It makes this more mysterious though. Now there are a couple more pictures. The SCP-1730 power station and message located on SW stairwell leading to third basement level, which says bleed with blood splattered. Well, that's comforting. I want to go in that basement. SCP-1730 is a large complex of structures 15 kilometers northwest of the US-Mexico border within Big Bend Ranch State Park that was discovered on June 5th, redacted. Oh, so it's buildings. Well, that the picture descriptions then would make sense. I mean, we've covered like the IKEA SCP, so that was also a creepy, mystical building. So I don't know why I'm surprised by this, but something about that it's just this huge block of area with buildings on it. That would make for one terrifying urban exploration YouTube video, wouldn't it? Due to the isolated nature of the complex and the low survival rate of individuals who come in contact with it, oh, it is possible that SCP-1730 has been previously discovered, but unreported. Because I guess whoever goes there meets an untimely end. Oh, that's lovely. That's comforting. That's wonderful. It's a bunch of buildings, not just one. So is it one overseeing entity? I mean, because it is considered just one SCP, but there's multiple buildings. So is an SCP going between the buildings? Is it the buildings themselves? I'm thinking of like a creature buried underground in like these little buildings or like it's like fingers or something. That was a really weird mental image. I apologize for that. The SCP bears identifying markings and contains documents to support the claim that the SCP was at one point Foundation Site 13. Oh, originally located near Nome, Alaska. This conflicts with current records, which show that Site 13 was a project that, while intended to be constructed in Nome, was scrapped for the larger and more advanced Site 19 and was never actually completed. So somewhere in those files, someone's covering something up. Which again, isn't surprising because these files are all redacted and they're top secret and they're full of things that are confusing. How SCP-1730 came to be at its current location is unknown. Okay, so even they can't explain how these buildings just move spot all of a sudden. And no one was there to say, yeah, this was actually completed. Why would they hide it though? Well, I mean, they're hiding a lot of things, so why would they not hide this? I actually would be the better question. This SCP is in a severe state of disrepair and appears to have been left abandoned for an extended period of time. So the dates are redacted though. So we're not supposed to know when this thing was found, and we don't really know when it was established because they think it's Site 13, but it kind of seems like it's like an urban legend because they didn't think Site 13 was actually completed. The site power generator has continued to operate in a damaged state despite a number of fuel leaks and fires throughout the facility. This has resulted in intermittent power failures throughout the site, hindering exploration and rescue efforts. The origin of this SCP is unknown, as in the nature of many of the anomalous entities contained within it. Ooh, entities within it. So there are creatures inside these buildings. Okay, that got even more terrifying. It is confirmed that the 2nd through the 15th basement levels were utilized for entity containment. So now are these creatures just out and about? They escaped? Okay, well now that explains the picture with all the blood. It is believed that a contingent of human survivors exists somewhere deep in the lower levels of the facility. Messages written in English have been discovered throughout the site, consisting of warnings such as danger and death here, and other messages such as not my body and bleed, like in the picture. Okay, so if people are alive, why would they go further and further into the depths of this building that is terrifying, that obviously there's things chasing it? No, maybe they don't have a choice. Okay, I'm kind of like answering my own questions as I go along here. A reoccurring message, what happened to Site 13, has been found in several different locations in the basements. So you're telling me there are a group of people living here that know something happened at Site 13, but nobody else outside knows what happened, or if they do, they're heavily concealing it from their own Foundation members? What big bad could be scarier than the other SCP that we've covered so far, that they felt the need to hide this one? The next SCP we're covering is SCP-012, and it is Object Class Euclid. Now, this is a pretty short one, and there's no pictures, sadly. Y'all know I love me some scary pictures, because it really helps cement the nightmare fuel. The description of this SCP is that it was retrieved by archaeologist K.M. Sandoval during the excavation of northern Italian tomb destroyed in a recent storm. Right away, I'm thinking of like ancient mummy tombs, and then going into it curses whoever is the first to enter it. So that's fun. The object is a piece of handwritten musical score entitled On Mount Golgotha, part of a larger set of sheet music. Appears to be incomplete. The red-black ink, first thought to be some form of berry or natural dye ink, was later found to be human blood from multiple subjects. That's wonderful. That sounds like SCP right there. If I were to ever find a creepy old looking piece of paper or like a painting and I thought, that color looks very odd, almost like it could be blood, I'm just gonna go from the presumption that it might be bodily fluids, you know? And I'm not touching that because it's probably cursed. And because it's nasty. First personnel to locate the sheet, Site 19 Special Salvage, had two members descend into insanity, attempting to use their own blood to finish the composition, ultimately resulting in massive blood loss and internal trauma. But it's a part of a larger set of sheet music. So how many people have fallen victim to this cursed music score? Following initial investigations, multiple test subjects were allowed to access the score. In every case, the subjects mutilated themselves. Oh gosh, okay. in order to use their own blood to finish the piece, resulting in subsequent symptoms of psychosis and massive trauma. Those subjects who managed to finish a section of the piece immediately took their own life, declaring the piece to be impossible to complete. Attempts to perform the music have resulted in a disagreeable cacophony, with each instrument having no correlation or harmony with the other instruments. So the music is a bunch of jumbled notes that sound like utter garbage when trying to be played. But like, if someone tried to play that, you think it would make the listeners go crazy, right? So what part is being cursed? Is it the actual sheet of music that's cursed? So like, is it the paper? But then they say there's multiple pieces of paper. So where's everyone getting these paper from? Like when they finish one and the next sheet needs to be started, where are they getting it from? Is it any? Is it just the act of a continued curse, seeing like the blood written? I got a lot of questions on this one too. And this is why the SCP is so fascinating, because they can make literally anything terrifying. A music sheet is now scary. So hey, for all those music composers out there possibly watching this, maybe don't use red ink if that's, you know, something you would use. Maybe don't. Play it safe. Use a different color. The last one we are covering today is SCP-1305, and it belongs to object class Euclid. And the picture caption says SCP-1305 during initial containment. And it's just a cat, right? It's just a cat? That just looks like a cat. Now I'm scared. I keep looking at it, not wanting to look away. It's a levitating cat. Okay, I'm scared. SCP-1305 is a mammalian organism with an ovoid body and 6 multi-jointed legs. It has one large flexible jaw located on the front of the body containing a long tongue and SCP-1305's lure. It weighs approximately 150 kilograms with a height of 2 meters, although it is known to be able to contort and compress its body to fit into a space 1/16th of its size. It's a creature that can make itself look like a cat, but really it's terrifying mountain lion. When active, SCP-1305 will attempt to hide itself in a dark enclosed area such as a cupboard or closet, which my cats do all the time. When it has hidden itself successfully, it may release a lure at the end of its tongue, most commonly resembling a domesticated animal such as a domestic cat. Wait, that cat from the picture is the tip of its tongue? What? Ew, gross. This lure will usually display behaviors expected of the organism it is imitating and attempt to bring human subjects to this SCP. Yep, I would fall victim to it instantly. I can't control myself. I see stray cats and I go up there and I pet them. I know I shouldn't. I know. I still do it. So, yep, this would be the one that gets me. In most cases, when a subject approaches the lure, it'll revert to the shape of a prehensile tongue wrapping around the subject's body. Oh gosh, sounds like a demented Pokemon. SCP-1305 will then attempt to bring the subject into its mouth and consume them. The consumption usually takes between 16 to 24 hours. That's a long time to be sitting in that thing's stomach, during which SCP-1305 will use the lure to draw in additional subjects. This thing has quite the appetite. As the SCP consumes additional organic matter, it will create additional lures, which it will send into the structure it inhabits. These lures will be highly audible, especially at times when human subjects are within the structure. In addition, these lures may take the form of subject SCP-1305 has consumed, so it can look like the people it's eaten. Say it's like someone's dad, and then like little Jimmy, his son, like comes home after school thinking it's his dad, and he goes up and talks to him, and then he gets eaten by this creepy creature too. Lovely. This process will continue until no prey organisms are left within the area, at which point the SCP will sever itself from its added mass and move on to a new area. I got a lot of questions. I can't quite visualize this one. But that does it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this SCP video. And if you would like to see another SCP video, please give it a big thumbs up. It really helps out this video, this channel, and this community, the Rad Fam. You guys are so rad. And if you have any other SCP creatures you would like to see me cover on this channel, especially this week, let me know down in the comments below. Leave the SCP file number as well as its name, and it can be made into a video. And until next time, keep it the radness, and I'll see you real soon. Bye. Yep, a cat would definitely get me. I would fall victim to that within 30 seconds of it showing up.